Why Allah give depression? Well, it's difficult to try to guess what Allah's intention is, because we'll never know. We'll never know what is Allah's intention, why does He give this, that, or the other. But it's unwise to assume evil intention towards Allah. Why do I say it's unwise? Because you're not helping anybody, especially yourself. But Allah does give us clues as to why, the big why of life. Number one, the clue is Allah is always merciful. Whether you see it or not, Allah is always merciful. Whether you see it or not, Allah is always merciful. That's why you start anything with Bismillah, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Allah is always merciful whether you see it or not. And sometimes we can't see the mercy in the moment because we're short-sighted. We don't see past the trial. But Allah sees everything, past, present, and the future. So perhaps, now this is me trying to guess what Allah is trying to do based on what I understand from the Quran. Perhaps the challenge, the test that Allah is giving you right now, which is depression, is the path that you need to go through in order for you to become a better person in the future. Right now, you don't see that. Again, you don't have all the variables. Allah does. So why does Allah give it to you? Because you're the right person to get this test. Allah doesn't give depression to someone else because probably for that person, that's not the right test to give. But Allah will give that person another test that you don't have. For example, maybe you don't have a divorced parent. You don't have a divorced parent, but somebody else does. They have a divorced parent. They don't have depression, but their parents are divorced. That's the test for them. And they might ask, why do Allah do this to me? So that question, although you have every right to ask that question, you have to understand it's not productive because you don't know Allah's real intention is apart from what He already established in the Quran, and that is He's always merciful and none of the things that He gave us are given to us without any reason. And all the tests that He gave to us is only for one reason only, is to see what you do with the test. So instead of asking why did Allah does this, ask another question. What am I going to do with it? So you have depression. I know it's hard. I know it's painful. But then, what are you going to do with it? Are you getting help? Are you getting professional help? Are you on medication? Are you going through therapy? Are you going through a treatment plan? That's what Allah is looking for. He's looking for what are you going to do about it? Because from there, He will give you the rewards that you have no idea how big of a reward that you're going to get from depression. From depression. So you're depressed. Okay, it's difficult. Somebody else lost a leg. Somebody else got cancer. Whatever it may be, Allah gave different people different tests. And I'm not trying to undermine your pain. No, I'm trying to tell you that there's a reason for all of this. Now, we can guess all we want, and you can choose which to guess. You can guess that Allah is trying to quote-unquote mess with you. You can guess that Allah is trying to quote-unquote punish you, but you're never going to know because, you know, it's an assumption. Or you can make a different guess. Allah is not punishing me. Allah is testing me to see if I can endure this. Ah, so sorry. I apologize. Instagram cut me off, so I can finish my answer here. So basically, Allah gives different people different tests in life, and I know me saying that sounds a bit cliche, and a lot of people are fed up of listening to it. Life is a test. Life is a test. Life is a test. Ah, enough is enough. I understand that. I understand that frustration, but it doesn't take away from the truth of that statement. Life is a test. And you're going to get different tests from different people. So you have depression. So you have a heart attack. So you have a diabetes. So you have failed your interview. You have whatever challenge or test that Allah is giving you, Allah gave it to you. Because in Allah's infinite wisdom, you're the right person to give this test to. Because Allah gave somebody else a different test that you don't have. Somebody else lost a leg, you still have your two legs. Allah did not give you that test. You still have both of your parents. Somebody else, their parents are separated or divorced, or maybe their parents passed away. So Allah gave different people different tests, and it's not a sign that Allah doesn't love you, Allah hate you, Allah trying to punish you. No, don't try to assume negative intention towards Allah, especially when you have no idea. Because Allah has all the variables that we don't have. We only see the immediacy of our situation. We don't see the future. We don't know the hikmah behind what we experience. Sometimes we do. Sometimes we see the hikmah, sometimes we don't. Most of the time we don't. We don't see the mercy. But it doesn't mean Allah is not merciful. It's just our inability to see it. And the best analogy that I can give you is, because I have a son, a 4-year-old son. And my son wants so many things that I do not give to him. And he can't see the wisdom behind why don't I give the things that he want. But I do, I see it. My son wants candy, I don't give it to him because I know that it's bad for his teeth. He doesn't know that, he doesn't see it. He doesn't see the wisdom and the mercy behind what I do. And that's similar to how Allah is with us. And I do it to my son out of love and mercy for my son, because I don't want my son in the future to not have functional teeth that he needs to use for tens and tens of years in his life. So I have that foresight in the future. I'm not saying that I predict the future, I don't know, but having this knowledge that, you know, candy is bad for your teeth, that's why I do it. That's why I prevent my son from eating too much candy. Sometimes I give it to him, but not all the time, and he gets angry at me for not giving to him what he wants. That's similar between us and Allah. We don't know the future and the wisdom and the mercy behind what Allah is doing to us. He doesn't give us everything that we want because He knows better what's in the future, and He knows better what's best for us. We don't know. We only know what we want. And just because you want something doesn't mean it's good for you. Just because you want something doesn't mean that you need it. Something that we have to understand, and it's difficult, I know, especially when you're going through this pain and you're trying to make sense of it, and you don't know, you don't see a way out, and you're trying so badly to endure and try your best to ask Allah, please help me, and you think that Allah is not helping you because Allah is not answering your prayer. But sometimes Allah does answer your prayer, but not in a way that you expect. Not in a way that you want. That's the other thing about prayer, is that you ask for something, yes, but Allah may give you a different answer. Allah doesn't left any prayer unanswered. It's just that the answer that He gave may not be the answer that you want, may not be the answer you expect. But believe that it's a better answer for you. And that's the only consolation words that I can give you, is that Allah knows best. Really, Allah knows best. We don't. And it's painful to hear, especially for people who are in pain right now. But the last point that I'd like to share with you is the Prophet's life. I mean, if your argument is that Allah is giving you difficulty because Allah doesn't love you, just look back at the Prophet's life. Any Prophet that you can think of, Musa, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet Nuh, Prophet Isa, all their lives is full of difficulties, full of pain and suffering, but it doesn't mean that Allah doesn't love them. Allah loved them the most out of anybody else in this world, prophets. But look at how they deal with it. And that's the key thing. Don't ask why Allah is giving me this difficulty, but ask instead, what am I going to do with it? Allah gave me, can't do anything about it, but I can do everything about how I'm going to deal with it. So the Prophet were given so many tests. Prophet Muhammad is a good example because he's the closest to us. He lost both of his parents. He didn't say, why are you not giving me parents? No. Instead, he deal with it. He lost his dearest wife. He deal with it. He cried. Yeah, it's okay to cry, but he deal with it. He didn't ask Allah, why you did this to me? No. Because he knows that Allah knows better than he does. So he went through war. He lost a lot of his dear companions. He lost his children. He buried a lot of his children. He buried himself. He buried those children himself. And he was persecuted, and people throw stones at him when trying to do da'wah in Ta'if. So you can read his sirah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you just try to figure out your life compared to his. And again, I'm not trying to undermine your pain. Your pain is painful. It's really painful. I wouldn't ask for the same pain for my son. But when Allah gave you that pain, meaning that He knows in His infinite wisdom that you're the perfect person to give it to. Somebody else has a different pain. We all feel pain differently, but that's our individual test. Don't give up. If you feel tired, take a rest, but don't give up. The journey is long, and you not giving up is probably the biggest reward that you can ever achieve in this world, by you not giving up. And you have no idea. You're gonna see that when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day, and He'll show you the mountains of good deeds that you received, and you have no idea, hey, where is this good deeds coming from? Well, you didn't give up. You did not give up. So I hope you keep going.